Hey everyone, welcome to Ian and Friends. I'm FloBikes senior editor Ian Dilly.
And I am Michael Sheehan. Today we are going to give you a recap of the Christmas week cyclocross races that just finished up, and we are going to introduce you to our 2019 cycling broadcast calendar.
So we just wrapped up one of the most wonderful weeks in all of cyclocross, 7 races over 11 days. Let's run down some of our highlights. What were some of your top moments, Michael?
First and foremost, Lucinda Brand. Wow, we saw her at Namur and Azincross. This is a rider I've been talking about really ever since we saw her at Overic. I think that she has just progressed so much as a cyclocross racer. We knew her well from road racing, but she has really practiced the cyclocross skills, and she is showing us just how technically proficient she's become this past year.
Yeah, Lucinda Brand has moved up into number one in our international cross rankings. You can go look at those on our site. Lucinda Brand is definitely the woman to watch heading into the World Championships. But we also, on the men's side, have Matthew Vanderpool, who it seems like the only person who can stop Matthew Vanderpool is Matthew Vanderpool, and he did a pretty good job of trying to stop himself over Christmas week, but didn't succeed.
No, even Matthew Vanderpool cannot stop Matthew Vanderpool at the end of the day. But he did actually have some human moments throughout Christmas week. He tangled himself up at the start of GP Sven Nys. He hit a pole, came off his bike early on. He had to chase. That ended up being no problem for him. He won the race handily. And in Degum, he had two mishaps. Once he ran into a course marshal, just head down, going as hard as he could. It was just when he took the race lead from Michael Vanternout. Came off his bike, looked like he tweaked his neck a little bit, but he got back to business. He also had a crash off camera, seemingly, that race, because he did finish the race with torn bib shorts, but again, in first place.
Yeah, I mean, the composure that Vanderpool has at this moment in time is just incredible.
Another impressive rider that we are getting the treat of seeing recently is Marianne Vos.
Yeah, Marianne Vos had just a phenomenal ride at Zolder, one of the best races of the entire Christmas series. Not only kind of using her strength as one of the, you know, the all-time greatest riders ever, 7-time reigning cyclocross world champion, really her guile and technical handling skill. I mean, she made a really astute attack on the last lap in Zolder to get a gap, and then just took the final descents faster than anybody else and ended up taking a World Cup win, keeping her World Cup lead. And she's really, what's interesting about her season this year in cyclocross is kind of picking and choosing her moments. Yeah, let's talk about another world champion, the 4-time reigning world champion, Zdeněk Štybar. He gave us some things to cheer about during Christmas week. Finally, kind of in the last race of the series at GP Sven Nys, I think maybe gained enough UCI points that was able to get a little bit better start position and worked his way all the way up to second place. We were definitely cheering from the commentary box for him, as it looked like he was, you know, gonna potentially give, you know, the leaders in this race a run for their money.
Yeah, throughout the whole Christmas series, he would claw his way up. Earlier in the week, he made it up into the top 10 after his last row start. But he doesn't quite seem to have the fire in the legs to be able to just hold that intensity for the full hour of racing against all these other cyclocross specialists. He, of course, is in a completely different phase of training, being a primarily road racer right now. However, what this means for the rest of his season, we really don't know. He is definitely taking a different approach. That being said, his skills on the cyclocross bike are never to be questioned. From hopping barriers flawlessly to the tail whips, he is so fun to watch. And if he puts his head down and continues to just chip away at this little deficit in intensity in his racing, who knows what Denmark may have in store for him.
Yeah, he has hinted that he's gonna compete in the Czech National Championships, and that would definitely bode well for a potential world's run. I'm holding out hope. Let's talk about guys who were unfortunately not hopping the barriers flawlessly during the Christmas week. We saw just a brutal crash from Tim Merlier. This was at Degum.
Tim Merlier, he took a really hard hit, came off the first barrier just wrong, launched him over the handlebars, and his torso landed on the second barrier. We really hope that he's healing up okay. I think that he was a little bit off his game because in the previous race, the Brico Cross Bredin, he was one of the very, very few riders who were hopping the barriers in that race. They were very close together. It was a really difficult barrier set, but he did have the confidence to hit them every lap. He had a minor crash the previous day, but maybe it shook him for the subsequent day in Degum. We hope he's okay. We're going to keep an eye on that situation, but it was a tough fall for him.
And then another rider showing just incredible technical skills is the Svennis 2.0, Thibaut Nies. Won the junior race at, you know, his and his father's home race in Ball, the GP Svennis, on his father's cyclocross course at the Svennis Cyclocross Center. And there's a set of stairs that everybody else was getting off to run. We saw footage on social media earlier in the year of both Sven and Thibaut actually riding this set of stairs. Thibaut put this to use in the junior race at GP Svennis, rode the stairs every lap, and ended up going on to win the race. Just incredible performance.
Yeah, I don't know if I'm jealous or if I feel bad for Thibaut Nies being Sven's son, because if you keep an eye on Sven's social media, Instagram videos, Thibaut trains hard under the guidance of Sven, but it is obviously paying off. The skills that this young rider is developing is going to be really, really something to watch as he enters the U23 and the elites. You know, being this young and having this skill set under his belt is pretty cool.
So our next race coming up is the DVV Series race, the Brussels University Cyclocross. A cool race, a relatively new course held right in the city of Brussels on the campus of the university. It's going to be an interesting course. We're not sure what to expect, but definitely tune in on Sunday. Michael and Johnny Sunt will be providing English commentary for that event. And
well, this one thing that we may see at this race is Wepen Aert cooling down on a trainer inside the podium tent, and this has caused a little bit of consternation amongst the podium presenters and competitors alike in cyclocross. But I say good on Wout. When you see a rider implement something, you know, it's easy to say, oh, he's being a princess, demanding time to cool down before he goes to the podium ceremony. Realistically, this is probably coming from above Wout's head, maybe from his new Jumbo team, because this is definitely a roadie tactic. You see all the roadies cooling down on trainers after every stage in a stage race, really after every race these days. And I think that Wout may just be starting a new trend in cyclocross. He's a bit ahead of his time right now, but 5 years, I'm calling it, every single rider is going to be cooling down on a trainer before their podium presentation.
It is really interesting. You know, I think part of what brought Wout to Jumbo-Visma was their really focus on his development as a rider. They have like a 5-year plan for him to become one of the best road racers in the world. So yeah, I mean, spending 10 minutes cooling down after an all-out hour intense race, on the face of it, it's smart, even if it doesn't really bode well with the Belgian media or you know, the other riders who want to get up on the podium and out of the cold weather. But yeah, it's a little bit of drama in the Belgian cyclocross world, not unsurprisingly.
Well, speaking of Wout, he is due to start his contract in March with Jumbo-Visma, the formerly Lotto NL Jumbo team. And this brings us into the classics, where we will see him race most likely.
And yeah, go to our site. We just released our 2019 confirmed broadcast calendar, and it is definitely a calendar we are extremely excited about. Racing starts in 2 short weeks at the Vuelta a San Juan, moves on to Spain, the Comunidad Valencia, and then into the Middle East and Australia with the World Tour races, Cadel Evans Great Ocean Road Race and the UAE Tour, and then straight into the Spring Classics.
Yeah, we have the Spring Classics for you. Tour of the Basque Country. We're gonna, again, go back to the Giro d'Italia. We have the Vuelta. The race calendar is incredibly stout. Take a look on our website. Be sure to look at the geo restrictions. We have some in Canada. We have some in the States. We have some rides shared. It is a big racing calendar on Flo Bikes, and it's only going to get bigger. This is just what we've confirmed so far. We're going to see a lot more Women's World Tour racing to come as well. Keep an eye out. It's going to be a really exciting year on the road.
And yeah, we're still working on building out our individual event sites for these different races, but we do have our full calendar, over 100 events, 300 days of racing.
Keep it right here. All the action is going to be happening on FloBikes. Happy New Year, everybody. It's going to be a good one.